Hey guys, welcome or welcome back to my channel. So today we are going to discuss another problem, but before going forward, if you've not liked the video, please like it, subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon so that you get notified whenever I post a new video. So without any further ado, let's get started. Problem is maximum erasure value. So in this problem, we are given an array of positive integers and want to erase a subarray containing unique elements. So we need to remove a subarray which has all the unique elements. The score you get by erasing the subarray is equal to sum of its elements. So whatever subarray we will remove, right, which has unique elements, if we remove that subarray, the score which we will get will be the sum of all the elements which are in that subarray. We have to return the maximum score we can get by exactly removing one subarray. Okay. What does the question is? See, this test case is given, right? This test case. Let me take this test case only. So, see, we need to remove a subarray. First of all, remove a subarray. Now, that subarray should have unique elements. Unique elements. That means no same element. Okay, no same element. Now, see, for example, let's take this subarray. Can we take this subarray? No, right? Why? Because 4 is repeating. We can take this subarray. Yes, we can take it. So, here, if we remove this subarray, the score we will get will be sum of the elements of the subarray. 2 plus 4 plus 5. That is 11. What also we can do is we can remove this subarray also. This subarray also has all the unique elements. So the sum we will get if we, score we will get if we remove this subarray will be 4 plus 5 plus 6. So this is what? This is 4 plus 5 plus 6. This is 9 and 15, right? This is 15. So another option is what we can do is, there is one more option, just try to think. So what we can do is we can also remove this subarray. So if we remove this subarray, see, this also has all the unique elements, right? So 2 plus 4 plus 5 plus 6. So the sum will be, score we will get will be 11 and 6, 17, right? So we have to return what? We have to return the maximum score. So by removing exactly one subarray, so we will be removing this orange subarray because it has more elements. See, it has more elements, na? So obviously, if it has more elements, it will give us more sum. So 17 will be the output because it's the maximum score. Okay, so this is what the problem is. Now let's see what we have to do basically here. We need to find a subarray. And that subarray should have maximum sum. So the problem is reduced that we need to find maximum sum subarray. We have to find maximum sum subarray. Right? This is the maximum sum subarray. So whenever you have subarray, right? And you have a condition that we have to find the maximum sum. So you can solve this using approach called as sliding window. We will consider all the subarrays, but we will be taking that one which has the maximum sum. Okay. So let's see how we can do it. So we have this test case 4, 2, 4, 5, 6. What we do basically in sliding window, so I will highly recommend, like before, after watching this video, you can also solve view the other two videos which are previous to this, because those are also based on sliding window. So see, first of all, what we will do, we will take a current sum variable, like which will tell us whatever the current sum is of the window. We will have a variable I, which will be the starting index of window. And we will have J, which will be the ending index of the window, or you can say the subarray. Then we will have an answer variable which will store the maximum score. Initially it will be 0. Okay, So now let's start. So first of all, I is also here, J is also here. So we will first move J forward. So we will move J and we will add the current element into the current sum. So it will become 4. J will come here. Now see guys, we have to, if you remember, there is one more constraint, right? We have to find maximum sum subarray, but there was a constraint that maximum subarray, you can apply Cardan's algorithm here, but you cannot apply that. Why? Because here we have another constraint that it should have unique elements. So we have to take only those subarrays which have unique elements. So how we will get to know that, okay, this subarray has unique elements? We have to store those elements, right? We have to have a count or something of those elements so that we can know that, okay, this element we have already encountered before, right? So for that, what I will be doing is, you can take a hash map, you can take a hash set. So I'll be using a hash set over here. So I have taken a hash set I have taken, and whenever I will encounter an element, I will add it into the hash set so that I can know that, okay, I have taken this element in my window, right? So 4 we have considered already. So current sum, you can say this is the sum of the window, the current sum of the window, and hash set has the current elements which are in the window, current elements in window. Okay, so now we will go to this J. We will see 2 is not in the hash set, meaning this is a unique element right now. We have not taken it earlier. So 2 we will add in the current sum. 4 plus 2 will be 6. And this 2 we will add here. Okay. Also side by side, guys, we will be storing this sum. We will check whatever the current sum is. We will update this answer. This answer will be maximum of the current answer and the current sum. Okay. So here answer will become 6 because this is 6. Now we will go move J forward. So J will come here and we will see 4. This 4 we have already taken in our window. Right now our window is this. So this 4 is a duplicate because this 4 is already in the hash set, meaning we have already taken it in our window. So what we will do now, we have to shrink our window now. We'll have to shrink our window. We will do what? We will move this I variable here. So now our window should be, so this window should be from this to this. This will be our window because window should have the subarray, or the window should have only unique elements, right? Now since we have removed this 4 from our window, what we need to do, just try to think. First of all, we have to remove this 4 from this hash set. But I will again add 4 because this 4 we have taken, right? So we'll add that 4. One thing is that we have, first of all, what we did, we removed from hash set. And then what we have to do, also we have to reduce the current sum because current sum is this sum, right? So already since there are 2 plus 4, 6 only, so basically when you will remove this element, right, you will subtract that from the current sum, so it will become 2. But since I have this 4 also, so 2 plus 4 will be what? 6. Okay. So this is what we need to do. Remove from the hash set and subtract from current sum. Now let's move J forward. So 5 is not in the hash set, so we can add it. Add in the sum, 6 plus 5 will be 11. Current sum, answer is 6 and current sum is 11. So we will update answer 11. And now we will move J forward. Now 6 is also not in the hash set, so we will add it 6 here. So now our window is D. Now our window is from this I to this J. Okay. We will add 6 in the hash set. We will add 6 in the sum. So this will be 17. And we will update our answer also, so it will become 17. And we have traversed the entire array C. And the answer is 17. So this is the maximum sum of a subarray having unique elements, right? Unique elements. So I hope you understood the problem and the approach. Also, you're clear with the dry run. Let's see the code once. So see in the code, very simple code, right? If you try to write code by yourself first, by seeing the dry run. So see, we have taken this answer variable. This is the current sum variable and the hash set. Okay, we are traversing in this here in the array, and what we are doing is we are checking if the elements in the window, while why we have while here, because there might happen na, that there are multiple duplicates in the starting. So like this is also in the hash set, so we only want unique elements, right? So until we are finding a duplicate, this means this find, if there is element present in the set, right, already present, so this will return a value, like it will not be equal to the end. So we have to erase that element from the hash set, and you need to subtract from the current sum, I will increment. Otherwise, if it's a new element, right, like for example 6 was a new element, so what we will do, we will add it in the hash set. So we add it in the hash set, we increment the current sum, and we update the answer. Okay, and at last we'll return the answer. So I hope you are clear with the this time complexity is O of n, and space complexity is O of n also, because we are taking a hash set. So I hope this was helpful. If you have any doubts, let me in the comments. If you found the video helpful, please like it, subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.